Hi viewers, this is Ravi Shankar. You are watching Ravi's Biology channel. In the last video, we have discussed about dicot stem and monocot stem. So in this video, we will discuss about the dicot leaf or dorsiventral leaf. Okay, the internal structure of dorsiventral leaf, the transverse section of dorsiventral leaf or dicot leaf shows three main important parts: epidermis, mesophyll, vascular bundles. Epidermis, mesophyll, vascular bundles. Three types are there. Now, we will discuss about epidermis, first layer. See here. So, epidermis is the outermost layer of the leaf, dicot leaf. Outermost layer of the dicot leaf. So, cells are present in the epidermis are one cell in thickness. I mean, single layer structure is present on the epidermis. Okay, cells are barrel shaped cells. In the epidermis, cells are barrel shaped cells. And they are arranged compactly without any intercellular spaces. Like dicot root also. So, the cells are barrel shaped cells. Cells are arranged compactly without any intercellular spaces. Okay, so the epidermis present on both sides. I mean, upper side and the lower side. So, the epidermis present on the upper is called upper epidermis, lower is called lower epidermis. And also called as upper epidermis is also called as adaxial epidermis. Lower epidermis is also called as abaxial epidermis. Adaxial is also called as upper epidermis. Adaxial epidermis is also called as lower epidermis. So here, so the epidermis which is covered by cuticle. So cuticle is also present, which is covered by epidermis. Also, stomata also present. Cuticle is also present and the stomata are also present on the epidermis. So, they are more on the lower epidermis than upper epidermis. Okay. Stomata present number of epidermis. So, more number of epidermis on the lower epidermis than upper epidermis. So, important one. Also, in some kinds of xerophytes, sunken type of stomata is also present. In xerophytes, in the lower epidermis, sunken type of stomata is present. Now, so another important one, epidermis gives protection to the inner tissues. Epidermis gives protection to the inner tissues. Next, important one, cuticle regulates the transpiration and also stomata helps in the gaseous exchange. So, important functions of cuticle is regulates the transpiration, stomata helps in the gaseous exchange. Okay. These are the most important points for the epidermis. So, second important one, mesophyll. Second part of the dicot leaf is called mesophyll. So, what is meant by mesophyll? The ground tissue present in between two epidermal layers. This one, two epidermal layers. So, this is the ground tissue present in between two epidermal layers is called mesophyll. The ground tissue present in between two epidermal layers is called mesophyll. So, mesophyll is chloranchymatous tissue. It is a chloranchymatous tissue. So, mesophyll is differentiated into two important parts in the dorsiventral leaf. What are they? Palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. Palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. First, we will discuss about palisade parenchyma. So, palisade parenchyma is present beneath the upper epidermis. Palisade parenchyma is present beneath the upper epidermis. So, cells are arranged in 3 to 5 rows. I mean, 2 or 5. I mean, 3 to or 2 or 5 rows. I mean, 2 to 5 rows are present beneath the upper epidermis. Also, intercellular spaces are narrow. Narrow intercellular spaces, not large. But in the spongy parenchyma, large intercellular spaces are present. But in the palisade parenchyma, narrow intercellular spaces are present. And also, mostly it is concerned with the assimilation of carbohydrates due to the presence of chloroplast. So, I mean, mesophyll tissue is chlorenchymatous. So, palisade parenchyma also chloroplasts are present. So, due to the presence of chloroplasts, it is concerned with the assimilation of food materials or carbohydrates. So, these are the most important points for palisade parenchyma. So, next to second one, spongy parenchyma. So, it is present towards the lower epidermis. Mostly, spongy parenchyma is found towards the lower epidermis. Also, it is also 3 to 5 rows of irregularly shaped and loosely arranged cells. See here. So, spongy parenchyma is arranged with loosely arranged cells. Irregularly shaped, loosely arranged cells. So, important one. So, intercellular spaces are, large intercellular spaces are present here. But here, narrow. Here, large intercellular spaces are present. And also, air cavities. Air cavities are found below the stomata. So, this is the air cavity. Substomatal cavity. So, mostly, I told you already, so more number of stomata are present in the lower epidermis. So, towards the stomata, so air cavities are present. So, air cavities are useful for the facilitation of gaseous exchange. So, spongy parenchyma is also useful for the, facilitates the gaseous exchange. So, here, in the spongy parenchyma, cells have less number of chloroplasts. Cells have less number of chloroplasts. So, these chloroplasts help in the synthesis of food materials also. So, these are the important points for spongy parenchyma. Next, third one, important one, vascular bundles. So, in the dicot leaf, third important one, vascular bundles. So, vascular bundles are extended in the mesophyll in the form of veins. So, vascular bundles are extended in the mesophyll in the form of veins. So, mostly, so these vascular bundles are bigger at the base of the leaf blade. Mostly, so vascular bundles are bigger at the base of the leaf blade and become towards smaller at the place of margins and apex. So, becomes smaller towards margins and apex. So, mostly vascular bundles bigger at the leaf blade, smaller at the margins and apex. And also, vascular bundles are conjoint, collateral, closed. So, in dicot leaf also, closed type of vascular bundles are present. Conjoint, collateral, closed type of vascular bundles are present. So, in the vascular bundles, xylem is present towards the upper side. Phloem is present towards the lower side. So, xylem is present towards the upper side. Phloem is present towards the lower side. So, vascular bundles help in the conduction of water, minerals and also food materials in dicot leaf. Vascular bundles are useful for the conduction of water, minerals, salts and also food materials. Important one. And also, it gives mechanical strength to the leaf also. So, another important point in dicot leaf. So, vascular bundles not only for useful for conduction of water and food, but also it gives mechanical strength to the leaf. It gives mechanical strength to the leaf. Another important function. And also, vascular bundles enclosed by special mesophyll cells arranged compactly. So, this layer is called bundle. See, this one. So, each vascular bundle is enclosed by special mesophyll cells. So, enclosed by special mesophyll cells arranged compactly. So, this layer is called bundle sheath. So, important one. So, bundle sheath, which is covered by vascular bundles in dicot leaf. Also, cells of bundle sheath extends towards the epidermal layers. So, both the layers, upper epidermis and lower epidermis, towards the upper and lower epidermis. So, extensions are this. See here. So, bundle sheath extends towards lower and upper epidermis. So, in between epidermal layers. So, these are called bundle sheath extensions. These are called bundle sheath extensions. So bundle sheath extensions are present. So between upper epidermis and lower epidermis. So they help in the conduction of food materials from mesophyll cells to the vascular bundles. Mesophyll cells to the vascular bundles. Okay. So these are the most important points for the dicot leaf. I mean dorsiventral leaf. Okay. So these are the important points for dicot leaf. So thank you very much. Thank you for watching.